Good morning. I'm Eckhart. I call myself the German butcher, but I'm also a home gardener. I do this gardening at home here for almost 50 years. I want to talk a little bit about it before I talk about what I'm cooking. Last year, I was trying to grow Brussels sprouts. So, and I put the plants out, and before I turned around, they were gone. So I thought we have rabbits. So I planted some more, and they're gone again. So then I put a fence around the area where I had the Brussels sprouts, and they were gone again. Then I found from the neighbor out that he has the similar problem. He didn't know what it was. But another neighbor said, yes, I see groundhogs in the backyard. So now we figured out what it was. And since I planted three times, I declared war against them. So, and what we did, we put out traps. The trapping season was on already for them. So I caught three little ones, actually four, but one was already too long in the trap. I was dead too long. I didn't want it. And we got the mother in the trap. And the father, my neighbor, shot it with a 22. He didn't get it, but he went underneath some concrete and he never came back out. So we had peace with the groundhogs. Except now I want to cook them. I prepared them already. They're little ones. They were young from the same, from last year, groundhogs. So one of them I put hamburger meat in. The only regular hamburger meat. Only this time I didn't use breadcrumbs because I didn't have any. I used oatmeal instead. I never did it before. I had no idea how it comes out. And I put some high density cheese in there. And then the other one, I just have onions and celery cut in small pieces and put some oatmeal in between with a little water. And of course a little spices, and that's it. Now the almonds themselves, I had overnight in 5% brine, because I like the meat better when it brines before. And put in a little pepper accent, little majoran to it, and that's it. See how it comes out. I have two of them, and the third one I cut in small pieces and fry here in the frying pan and make it brown. There will be something like Hasen pepper. I cooked it only a few times, but it came out always pretty good. The last time was Wyoming hunting. Somebody shot a rabbit with a high power rifle. He was lucky, he just shot the head off. So I made the Hasen pepper out of it. It was very good, but I never did it before, but still okay. I forgot to mention the two I have in here. Maybe you can see it better when I turn it around. I browned them before I put them in here and put the bacon over it. I have no idea how that will be later on. But for extra smoke flavor, I put in each part later on half a smoked jowl. Be honest, if I like the meat, this is enough for me for tonight. And now I'm frying my meat here. If the stain is still frying pan, I wonder how it sticks on to it. I had an ultra salted in brine. But then I put spices on, and before I put it on, I put some flour on it. So I hope it will be okay. I know I fixed up something. This one, I just put a cover on and put it down. I go on 320 degrees. 2 hours, 3 hours, I don't know. I like to have it obviously very, very done. when I cut it, the groundhog, I had the impression that the groundhogs are vegetarians. They eat only grass or green stuff. And I was surprised that I found gallbladders in there. That means they eat sometimes some meat too. Now, somebody asked if that's okay to eat it, if it's safe. They were now a few months in the fridge. And now I cook it, we're done. I'm 100% sure there should be no problem with it. I didn't see that about 3 months in the fridge. If they have trichinosis, it definitely will kill. You know, trichinosis is killed by freezing. Now I took that meat out of the frying pan, put it in my roasting pot or whatever you want to call it, and then put some onions, green celery, and bacon in it. So let it cook a little, and then I add water to it to get all the stuff that is fried onto the frying pan out. That will make the gravy better later on. Here I have a piece of meat yet. This was the hamburger I put in the one of the animals. And you can see there's some cheese in it. But I had no more room in there, so I will put that in here and cook it for a while. Once I think that's done, I will take that out earlier. And the same thing, the other half of my jowl, I put in here. That's the backup. Gives me a better smoke flavor. That's why when I roast something, I'd always like to have smoked meat in it. I want to go back to trapping the animals. I trapped them last year. And if you trap stuff around the house, you don't need a trapper's license. All you need is a habitat stamp. Then you can trap in season around the house. Now I put my stuff all back in the pot. When there's some water on it, it scrapes all the brown stuff off. That's why I like to use the stainless steel pan, not the nonstick pan. You might scrape it off. And that's it. Now it goes on here, but I take it upstairs so I don't have to run down all the time. And this you can set on 180 degrees or 200, or let it cook a little slow. Now it's about an hour past. I'm going to show what I have in the pot. This is my meatloaf, that's almost done. This is my jowl. And those are the pieces of meat. They are still not soft enough. I let it cook for a while. I may take the meatloaf out soon, so. Now in the evening, and everything is well done, I want to show short what I did. I took the meat out and put it in two plates. Those are the groundhog, and this is my meatloaf and the jowls. Then whatever was left in the bacon and the onions, whatever I had in here, I put it in a mixer, the drink mixer, and made it real fine. Added it back in the pot and added some heavy cream in it, but it was so heavy I didn't have to put any starch, you know, no thickener in it. It is so good this way. And if you eat it, very, very good. The smoke flavor is there. Normally you have to put some spices to it. This is finished. I don't have to put nothing to it. So now, like I said, the groundhog I cut in small pieces. I don't want to eat it now. And here my jowls and my hamburger meat. Hamburger meat, of course, I ate some already. You can tell here I spilled some. And my jowls. Of course, the jowls, this is my favorite. I can't get enough of that stuff. Now I have the last two rabbits. Rabbits, so-called. Or groundhog laying here. I want to explain that a little bit very quick. Number one, I took the liquid out of the frying pot, and put a mixer and made a gravy out of it. But this time I had to put some cornstarch in it to thicken it. And I had to add a little salt to it. It was not perfect. But now it's good. But now I have here the two groundhogs. The one I had filled with vegetables, and I discarded it. I didn't like it. Didn't taste that good. But the meat tastes good. But I'm talking, this is the vegetables I had in there with, what you call it, Haferflocken drin. I don't remember the English word for it. I looked it up, oatmeal. So, because last night when I did this, I had no breadcrumbs, so I used in my hamburgers also oatmeal. Otherwise the same what I have for the previous movie. So, but if I taste the meat, I pick a little meat here, there is very little on it. Even this one tastes very good. This one I already tasted, is also good. But I want you to look at my hamburgers. They look nice. I have a little cheese in there. And otherwise, just like my regular hamburger meat when I make fricadellen. It tastes very good. And of course, a little bit bacon. What I will do now, I will pick the meat off the bones and put a container, put the gravy on top of it. And then comes in the fridge or freezer and eat it whenever I have time or when I need it. I ate so many jowls, I don't need no food anymore today. Now I took all the meat off the bones, except the Hasenpfeffer, I left the bones in. That is this one, with some gravy in. This is the hamburger meat, the meatloaf I had. And those are two, the meat from the, what I picked off from the bones. And I put them now in the freezer and take them out as we need them. There's always enough for two persons in there. Now we come to the end of my Groundhog Day. I hope you like my movies, like my others. You find them on YouTube under Eckehart, the German Butcher. And share if you like him. Thank you. This time we had something to do with wild game, so I easily can say Weidmannsheil. That's what in Germany, what every hunter says.